We saw Florida Governor Ron DeSantis try and troll Democrats by signing an anti-vaccine mandate bill in Brandon, Florida, where he was greeted with cheers of Let's Go Brandon, which, as we know, right-wingers think that that's like a slam on Joe Biden or whatever. The Democrats have been turning that around in the last week or so and saying Let's Go Brandon after the Democrats got all that stuff passed in the House. But you also had CPAC putting out a tweet banning Big Bird and Ernie. I wish we were making this up. This is not The Onion. It says they're going to ban Big Bird, Bert, and Ernie because they endorsed vaccinations. Help me out here, Kirsten. You know, when I went to CPAC, it didn't go well either. So, and I'm not a Sesame Street character, despite what some people might think. But
I'm honestly speechless. I like banning Big Bird. This is, you know, this is what excites voters, that you have to be so, have such purity tests that you use it for puppets. It's just taking it to a new level. And unfortunately, it's a very serious issue, right? So it can seem funny, except for the fact that people die because they listen to this kind of stuff, that people believe that, that getting a vaccine is not good for them or not necessary. And our hospitals are filled with people who are dying of COVID, who could be alive, and also taking hospital beds from other people who are sick. So, yeah. It has very deadly consequences.
Yeah. And Chris, I mean, but it's just absurd. You've been to these CPACs. I mean, it used to be, I know there was a certain level of trolling that always existed at CPACs, but this is so bizarre. It's like a different universe compared to the CPAC that we used to, you know, attend as reporters like 5 years ago.
Well, it used to be a lot of fun. It used to be interesting because you had different kinds of conservatives. If there was an interplay, it was a good microcosm of the American right with the different points of view represented. But here's the problem with that. It's not a very good business model. It doesn't work as well. And now they're trying to, they've shipped it overseas. They've had CPAC Brazil, which apparently was with the authoritarian regime down there backing them. So the CPAC model is, it's right-wing populist nationalism that relies on rage and outrage and the constant spin cycle of umbrage. So it's not a place for ideas anymore. And that's by design. So we'll just have to go look someplace else.
Kirsten, let's talk about the future of the Republican Party, which I suppose we have been doing to some extent. But today, Texas Senator Ted Cruz declined to say whether he's running for president in 2024. Let's watch.
Look, I have no idea what's going to happen in 2024. Donald Trump is going to have to make a choice, first of all, whether he's going to run or not. I think if he chose to run, he would be very, very formidable. I can tell you that when I ran in 2016, we came incredibly close. Mm-hmm. I came in second. There's a long history of runner-ups becoming the next nominee, and it was the most fun I've ever had in my life. But there's a lot of time between now and 2024.
What do you think, Kirsten?
Well, I think there's a looming question about whether Donald Trump is going to run. And so if Donald Trump is going to run, then of course Ted Cruz is not running. That goes without saying. He's been there, done that, didn't go so well. So I think that once he sees what's going to happen on that front, I'd be very surprised if Ted Cruz didn't run for president in 2024.
Yeah, Chris, I mean, he almost sounds like he's on bended knee to some extent.
Do you believe him when he said it was the most fun he ever had running for president in 2016? Didn't sound like it. Didn't sound like it was a thrill ride, as Donald Trump said his wife was ugly and his dad killed Kennedy. So I feel bad for Ted Cruz in a way, because he's raised all this money. He has all these backers. So he's almost obliged to run. But the dogs don't like the dog food with Ted Cruz. He's not been popular among Republicans, even though he has tried to articulate whatever view they want at any given moment. So I think he's sort of in a jam.